nice to meet you too, Montel.
You too, sir.
You want both of them? Or just one?
Just one.
Motai, appreciate you. That's Motai. He's a singer. Over in Georgia, but he got like a real popular like winter song. His name Motai. M U L. Motai. M U L dash T-Y. Last words to infinity and beyond. Out of here, Jack. Okay. Me to heaven. Go be here. Big God.
Big one.
Congratulations. Thank you. I go when I'm ready. I'm on that song. Get bouncing. Y'all turn up then! Hey. Thank y'all. Hey, look good. It's all right.
Good.
Yeah. Yeah. You first, bro.
Thank you, bro.
I know. Yeah, they flight got rerouted like 3 times. It's crazy. I just get one on one. Thinking that now sorry for everybody who's listening live. No singer.
Mama. Come here, Mama. Mama. Mama.
Yeah.
Jack Tudor.
Huh? No, this, love you, baby. Some love. All right. Flower Girls. Go to mommy. Look at her.
Good job. Good job, mama.
Let's go, Zuri.
He smiled at it. It might be dope.
Huh?
Two.
If you go grab a hand. If you go escort her, that'll be
yeah,
dope.
Yeah. She got. Excuse me, fellas. Bye. First sax player with a deal with Jordan.
For real?
Mm-hmm. He really good. Old school. He been had a deal since like the 90s. Michael Phillips. Yeah.
So I used to write for his beat.
Oh, wow.
Keep up the brand that comes.
he played at Notori's parents' 25th anniversary when she was like 12. Who got the rings?
I got one.
Okay.
She gonna have the band. I got the band on my pinky.
Okay.
Yeah, put it on the left finger.
They, who gave you the ring back?
Okay.
Gives his bride to be married?
I do.
Savior? Creating this day and for bringing us all into agreement as we stand in faith for these two lives as they prepare to become one in Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody said amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today before God and this assembly to join together in holy matrimony, Notori Cora Maria Naughton and Xavier II Lewis. Sometimes we can forget that marriage is not just about the couple's relationship. It's a relationship between the couple and God. He must be the third partner in this vital piece of a sacred covenant between husband and wife. Nobody on this earth created marriage. God did. And from the very beginning, it was created to be a sacred covenant. That's why marriage is more than a contract. It's more than a commitment. It's more than an agreement. It's more than an institution. It's more than a contract because contracts can be broken. It's more than a commitment because commitments can become uncommitted. It's more than an agreement because agreements become disagreeable. It's more than an institution because institutions can become mental institutions. But a sacred covenant is an everlasting union. Marriage is a spiritual covenant that represents the promise that God's love never fails us. In Him, all things are possible. And just like His love for us is forever, He desires for marriage to reflect the same unending love for each other that He has for us. Now, if there is, please feel free to leave now and never hold your peace.
I got it on me. I got it on me.
You're not the groom. You're not a part of the covenant relationship, and you got bad timing. This is how we do it. My wife, Kristen, and I, we've been married to each other for nearly 30 years. And we've had the privilege of educating and counseling and guiding this couple for almost half a year now. And I am a witness that I've seen two people who really love God and they love each other. Amen. And they wanted to share their love with you today. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And he saw it was good. He created the stars, the sun, the moon. He saw it was good. Good, good. He saw it was good. And he saved the best for last. When he created a man, that it was good. And he rested. Now get this, y'all. The only time during all of creation where God said it was not good was when he saw that the man he created was alone. Genesis 2 and 18 says this, and the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make a helper comparable to him. And Eve, an interpreter. So to the congregation, that's why we're here today. We are here to witness Genesis 2 and 24, where a man shall leave his father and his mother to be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And so we get front row access to witness a miracle where one plus one plus one equals one. Somebody missed that. You see this plus one equals one. Now before we can actually witness this miracle take place, I want to share another miracle with you. Xavier, have you received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes, I have.
Naturi, have you received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
I have.
Upon public profession of your faith, you have made known to all men and all women that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. I want y'all to get this. Jesus said to Peter in Matthew 16 and 18 that upon this rock, what they just said, upon this rock, I'm going to build my church. That profession of faith that you believe in your heart, you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, he died on the cross, was raised from the dead for our sins. That is a miracle. That you both are now being joined together, and you now join yourself to him. Jesus says, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. That is the template for you to model in your marriage, and it's going to be the central piece that holds you together. Because this proclamation of your faith, God's word says that you stand cleansed and forgiven from all your past. You're a new creation. Hold towards each other and never allow the sun to go down on your wrath. Right, the bride and groom have prepared some vows that they'd like to share. And so they're going to do that at this time. And we're going to start with Xavier.
Okay, now. I thought it was ladies first. I don't know. I just play. Everybody kept telling me that your wedding day goes so fast. Like it's already a blur. I hope life with you goes slow.
Get on that mic. Let him hear you, baby.
I believe in God's you. Can I take my time to just admire you? Yeah, my baby. Love is not a feeling. It's an act of a will. It takes just a moment for me to say I love you, but I will spend my lifetime working to show you. I will spend an eternity loving you, caring for you, respecting me to love. He picked you out from all the rest because he knew I would love you the best. And even until the heavens above no longer exist, even until them shall me, but now I know I'll never die. But if I should die before you do, I'll go to heaven and wait for you. If you're not there by judgment day, then I know you went the other way. Break stuff off.
I feel like mine might be a little long-winded.
It's all good.
But at least on my two, I'm getting signs of 222 for the last 6 months, and I realized that the angels, their angel numbers, they're trying to send me a message to see the good in my life, to accept the positive. The message is to love you, to support you, to recognize that God blessed me just by meeting you. You know, when I met you, babe, I was so broken and I was so afraid. And you make me feel so safe. You are my safe place. You are my home. You are my rock. And you are my wildest dream, but in color. I think, but I didn't know it was possible. And just being with you and your family and you opening up your heart. but I vow to be a good wife, to be a good teammate. I vow to you to know that I can't wait to build more children, more life with you, travel with you, do it. And you know that my need to be right has often been behind my life and in love. It's okay to make mistakes because I know you'll be the pieces. It's okay to surrender my soul to you. I vow to give it all to you. No matter what we're going through, I will be here to the end. No matter what happens in this lifetime, to be beyond, I got you.
I know.
Come back to 6.
Oh, good. Oh, thank you. I said at the beginning, this is y'all taking notes, right? Then we have the ring. Hold that for just a second. Yeah, you can. I'm just going to grab it and hold it for just a moment. A ring is a very precious thing, y'all. Token of your faith and of your love. It has no beginning, it has no end. It's a reminder of the constant and continual love of God. Xavier, you have now already committed your life to Christ, and so now you get to commit yourself to Matsuri before she commit herself to you. So I'm going to ask you to, as you're facing your best friend, to take her hand and prepare to place the ring on her finger. Xavier 2 Lewis, do you take Matsuri Cora Maria Nott to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love her, to honor her, to cherish her, to protect her, to have and hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others until death do you part? He said, then repeat after me. Matsuri Cora Maria Norton.
Matsuri Cora Maria Norton.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
You can place the ring on her finger. Matsuri. Xavier has now laid down his life before you and before. It's now safe for you to give yourself to him as he has given himself first to the Lord and now to you. And it takes two to make a thing go right. Shout out to Rob Bates. Right. Put your hand, prepare to put the ring. Matsuri Cora Maria Norton, do you take Xavier 2 Lewis to your lovely husband, to love, honor, cherish, to respect him, to have, hold from this day forward for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, and help take all others until death be part?
I do.
Then repeat after me. Xavier 2 Lewis.
Xavier 2 Lewis.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Place the ring on his finger. Y'all turn and face me. Let's pray, please, by your heads. Father, your word says that he that finds a wife finds a good thing. And thanks be to the Lord. Xavier has found his good thing. lives that come with long life, health, prosperity, family, happiness, strength, children, whatever blessing you have, them open up the heavens and pour down on this couple. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We're almost there, y'all. Everybody that's here today, you are an important part of this marriage and this new family because you are witnesses. As a community of their family, of their friends, we are witnesses to this union so that we know how to pray for them and to encourage them and to bless them to be all that God has called them to be together. Anything you may be doing that is not causing them to come together, you're not being a good witness. Because you're supposed to witness what you're seeing today. We pray for them for strength, solid, happiness, prosperity. That's our job. Do your job. Today, Saturday, April 2nd, 2022, in the great state of Georgia, as a representative of Almighty God, His Son Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband. Enslaved ancestors who were separated and not allowed to legally marry, the jumping of the broom symbolized a sweeping away of their past lives separate from each other and coming together in solidarity and unity as one. And so we recognize our challenging past as we now celebrate this bright and present future. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Xavier and Aturi Lewis.
Hope we see y'all later. Yeah. So after that, we post. Yeah, we're going to stay right here because we got to come back. What's up, wife? Are y'all eating? I know y'all was.
My whole thing is when I walk in there for me.
Yeah. The timing, the little punches, that was.
Whatever, baby.